Hey everybody, it's Norm from Tested here, and today we're going to be building and testing the RoboMaster S1. This is the new RC robot from DJI. Now, you might know DJI as the makers of drones, multi-rotors, gimbals, cameras, but not a lot of people know that over in Shenzhen, they've been running the RoboMasters competition for the past couple of years. This is a massive event where students from universities from all around China come together and basically build robots in this real-time strategy game. The robots are engineered with AI, with these blasters. They go around these huge arenas, and it's this massive, massive event. And so this is the first consumer product that's an educational robot that's inspired and based off of the lessons learned from the RoboMasters competition. And it is, of course, a kit. Just look at this. You got tons of parts. There's the chassis, the wheels, the motors with built-in speed controllers. You have the body plating. There's the blaster. There are even some hit plates to know when you're being hit. And of course, an FPV camera. This is gonna be so awesome. Let's get to building. So that was the build. And first of all, this was so fun to put together. It took about 2 hours. All the tools from the screws, the drivers, all the cables are packed in that box, and the instructions are pretty clear. There's a jig for these wheels, and actually on the side of these are actually target plates. Behind each of these chassis armor plates, what you see in this light here is a sensor, pressure sensor, as well as a light sensor, so you can engage in some fun combat and some dueling with other tanks. It all connects and is controlled via an app. So there's a new RoboMasters app by DJI, and from there you get, as you would expect, FPV driving. So I have it loaded up right now, and I found the latency to be really, really good. It's using probably the same digital signal technology over Wi-Fi, either over through your router or direct connection to the robot, as the other DJI FPV camera systems. And so very low latency, and of course you're not flying this several hundred meters away. This is gonna be contained driving around in your room or your backyard or in some type of, you know, gymnasium. I was able to pilot this completely just using FPV, and it's two stick controls. So you have lateral movement as well as gimbaled movement. You can see some of the gimbal movement here. It's all analog. You can move as slow or as fast as you want. And it turns right here, but it's really that lateral movement that really impressed me, because as you can see, these are mechanum wheels. Now, if you don't know what those are, they're basically a wheel design that has omnidirectional movement. You can see that along with this one axis of movement, these wheels don't actually pivot. There's no system in place here to let the wheels actually turn individually. And that's part of the elegance of this design. As opposed to a traditional car or RC vehicle, you're not steering by turning the front two wheels left and right. Instead, each of these wheels have a series of rollers, and that allows for not only lateral movement, I can move this left and right and strafe essentially, but then a combination of different speeds and forward and backward movement from each of these wheels allows for turning. And the turning is super smooth. The whole drive system is super smooth. I was shocked just turning this on the slowest, most basic speed, how responsive it was, because it's running these brushless motors and speed controllers from all the years of experience that DJI has developing those technologies on their drones. All of that is inherited onto this RoboMaster S1. So very, very satisfying driving experience with the app or an optional control pad accessory and driving via FPV. In fact, I had to use the same type of mental gymnastics of look at the FPV and not look at the vehicle because I have this running around the room and going all different types of orientations. Now above the main chassis, of which there are those four armor plates, there is this blaster system, which is on the gimbal. And the blaster is really cool because it has dual functionality. It can work either as an infrared blaster system, it fires just a little bit of a beam right there, or it actually can fire these gel pellets. And these gel pellets are very soft. They're not like BBs, they're not like airsoft pellets. They're almost like a little harder version of a tapioca pellet, like boba milk tea pellet. And so very easy to squish, and you actually reconstitute these by soaking them in water for up to 4 hours and put it in a hopper in the back. And then you could fit up to 400 of them in here and drive them around and hit the other targets. And there are safety measures in place, so you can't aim it very high, no more than 10 degrees up and down before you fire one of these pellets. Well, I actually had the most fun just using the infrared laser from the front to go hit the other targets. And speaking of targets, there is computer vision on the RoboMaster. It's the camera here, camera module that not only allows you to record video at 1080p, 30fps to a micro SD card or to your connected mobile device, but also allows you to recognize human objects, recognize gestures, the same kind of things that DJI's drones could previously recognize, could follow you around, but also recognize tracking markers. So it includes a set of these paper markers, you set them up, and it allows you to do things like have a race, whether it's a time trial where you have these set up and run around, see how long it takes for you to capture each of these, or if you have multiple RoboMasters, you can actually then have a race, a course, and then drive around, find the targets, and there are even some targets that allow for power-ups, for speed boosts and armor, to really make it like Mario Kart, but a physical vehicle, RC vehicle in real life. I had so much fun just driving this around. Again, the control systems are super responsive, and because there's analog controls, I can move as slow or as fast as I want. But the RoboMaster S1 is also made as an educational platform, and that's, I think, their primary intent. And so there is a system in place for you to program movement actions, program a little bit of AI into the robot, and it's super simple. It uses either Scratch or Python, and with Scratch blocks, it really is just drag and drop. They have parameters for the computer vision, parameters for the sensors, for the hit detection, for the orientation of the gimbal, and you can do things like design juke maneuvers, or if you have a pellet hit on one of the targets, you can then have it spin around and fire back in the other direction. All sorts of different things that you can command, and we just have basically scratched the surface of the programmability of the RoboMasters. Of course, with every RC device, one of the considerations is battery life. It includes one battery with this, and charging it takes about an hour and a half. It gives you about an hour of charge, which I found was plenty for driving this around. The place where I wish I had more battery life was when using the programming, because I want to debug the program, the actions. If I'm spending 15 or 20 minutes creating a sequence, I don't want to have the RoboMaster off and on and switch it back on to do a test, and there's no virtualized version of it in the app yet that I know of. So it kind of sucks. I need to leave this on while I run the debug for the operations. But I think they will sell extra batteries. And for driving around, for going into some competition, an hour of runtime is actually pretty good. All of this right now, I'm impressed that they got all this technology in on this kit that's super fun to build, and all this technology onto something that's basically $500. I can't imagine another company putting out all this tech on this an RC device for that price, I think that DJI is getting a lot of benefit from all their engineering and all their experience working on drones into putting it into a device like this. I was kind of skeptical going into this build. Like, why is DJI making this RC vehicle when their expertise is in flying cameras, these great drones that can capture amazing video? And it kind of makes sense. They share a lot of the same basic technologies, from the computer vision, from the gimbal systems, to the motors and the speed controllers and FPV controlling. And I'm just having a ton of fun with this. Again, we've barely scratched the surface with RoboMasters, and we're gonna get another one of these units and do some actual programming and do some trials and do a little bit of head-to-head competition with these, and we'll be back with a future in-depth test in the future. But if you have questions about the RoboMasters S1, place them in the comments below. I'd love to answer them, and I can't wait to get this back on the road.